την οικονομική τους ενίσχυση και την αγάπη τους. Γιατί πίστεψαν και ακόμα πιστεύουν σε αυτό που αντιπροσωπεύει το σχολείο μας. Στους μαθητές και στον ρόλο της παιδείας στην διαμόρφωση ατόμων τα οποία θα είναι χρήσιμα στην κοινωνία μας.
Our school Sahetsi, the gem of the Greek community, has been truly blessed with benefactors, generous, selfless individuals that give of their time and money, that give of their life because they believe in the school, in its mission, in its pupils, and the role of education in the formation of cultured, well-rounded persons that will be an asset to society.
Among our most recent benefactors is the Bylos family. They saw the need for a venue in which music was both taught and appreciated.
With their backing, their vision, and labor of love, this need was addressed, and what materialized is what we see around us. This evening is a tribute to their love. Thank you.
Concert. And thank you to Mr. McCurdy for asking us and to Diana Cohen for organizing us. We appreciate it very much indeed. And thank you also for your kind words of welcome, head boy and head girl. Just so that you know who we are, my name is Bunny Ashley Boerter, as Bunny as in rabbit. And our accompanist is Elmer Swanepoel. And we are very happy tonight to have two old boys, ex-jockeys as we call them, from presently at St. Albans College, Mark Leathers and Gareth Trent, who are helping us with the sound. So thank you very much to you two at the back there. And you may also be interested to know that we do have quite a close connection with Sohetti because of the fact that we have an ex-jockey here too. He's a matriculus here, and his name is Walter Mokgotsi. So we are tied together. And it's very nice to be here tonight. So we're going to continue now by singing for you Domine ad adjuvandum me festina. It is a piece by Ommelius from the 18th century. And it is it's in Latin, and it translates as, Lord, bless this our festival day. So we thought that that would be quite an appropriate piece to sing. Accompaniment. We didn't bring an orchestra tonight, though. We brought Elma instead. it's in several movements. And the first one is Hear My Prayer, and it's sung by Paul Gooday, who is 12 years old and comes from Swaziland. With Paul, and on his left is Bjorn Brouterseth. He's 12 and from Johannesburg. They always like it when I say that they're older than they really are. And then Matthew Wilkie takes over later. He's 13 from Johannesburg. And Tristan Trent sings a little recitative in the middle as well. He's 12. He's from Kriersdorp. And Michael Miller, he's 11. And he comes from Addis Ababa in Ethiopia. So that's the last seller. Here are the first two. song, Jesus uns Löwe, but we do it with ethnic movements, you see, so we think it's good cross-pollination. Raymond, who's 14, he's from Pretoria, and Marcus Benyons, he is 13, and he's from Mpangeni. They grow at different rates at this age. And on drums, we have Paul again, and Wesley Deeble. Just stand, Wesley, so they can see. That's Wesley Deeble, he's from Johannesburg, he's 18. And Michael Brannigan Barrett, who is, he's really 13. 14. He's from Pretoria as well on percussion.
Yeah.
by Haydn, and it's called the Little Organ Mass because of this particular Benedictus, which has an organ obbligato in it, which means it's like an organ solo part, which I play on the piano. But we do have a lovely organ in our auditorium back at school, and we are also doing a special thing, opening it for the first time. We're going to be opening it in our festival Music in the Mountains, which takes place from the 27th of April to the 1st of May. And this is one of the pieces we'll be doing down there. And so if you'd just like to imagine that you're hearing an organ. concert, ladies and gentlemen, but we're about to sing Time to Say Goodbye. On trumpet, Simon Corr. He is 14 from Belcourt. And the soloists are Sebastian Silk, who is 14 and he's from Freyheit. And Craig Lubber is 15, he's from the Vale Park, and he's the head boy of the school and the head boy of this choir. Craig, please just put your hand up. Marcel Lombard, who's 13 and he's from Turfontein, Dean Kagan, who's our deputy head chorister, is the second soloist. He's from Cape Town and he's 14. And Vernon D'Souza, 12 years old. Are you 12, Vernon? Yes, he's 12. He'd wished I'd said 13. He's from Standerton. Simon Korb, who played trumpet a moment ago. So they're pretty versatile, these.
Far away, so far,
much for your very warm and generous applause. It's wonderful. Thank you. We're going to sing one more song now before interval. But I understand, or I see, hiding back there with some wonderful refreshments. I'm not sure whether I should have mentioned that or not. But we do have available chocolates. They're special chocolates to commemorate this concert tour that we're doing with Lina Hichu, whom you might know, South African soprano. They're very nice pictures on the wrapper. So they're old chocolates in new wrappers. And we also have available, this is the commercial break, by the way. We have videos, and which are one on a Christmas video, very nice one, and another one that was broadcast on SABC called Hosanna. And they're quite a selection of CDs, should you be interested. After interval, we'll be singing some African music, and there's a whole African music CD called Shosholoza, and several others that you might like to browse through. And then, if there are any young boys in the audience who'd like to audition, I'm available afterwards for anybody that would like to audition. We're not looking for Pavarottis, we're looking for motivated kids who are reasonable at their academic work. And if they've got a nice ear, then we can take them further. So that is about interval. And now the song that we're going to sing for you now is called Poor Wandering One. It's from the Gilbert and Sullivan show, Pirates of Penzance. And it's actually known as Mabel's song, but we call it Poor Wandering One. And the two solos you've met, Tristan and Michael.
Take any horse, take us. Doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles.
Sparkies that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Moons in white dresses and corsets and sashes.
Snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes.
Silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when the bee is sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad. Oh, it's the sound of music. Oh, dear, 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 red all the time.
Thank you.
Receive a present from our head boy and Diana Kern to come up and receive a present from our head boy. And we wish hereby to say thank you very much for having us. Mind just coming forward to receive just an empty envelope. Now, if you'd be patient a moment while we rearrange the stage for the African adventure. Boys, I would like to say thank you very much to our hosts and hostesses. We have got parent hosts as well. It's lovely of you to host your own children and to host others as well. And to all the host parents of Sahiti, thank you very much indeed for welcoming us, opening up your homes and making us feel really at home. So please, a round of applause. Also for the refreshments that we received in interval. They revived us greatly. And now a word or two about the African music program. There's some songs that have been added in and others that we're not singing. But what may be of interest to you is how we learnt these songs. We've learnt them in several different ways from neighboring schools in our valley. We've learnt them from boys who've come to the school and taught us the songs. We've learnt them from visiting choirs, and very few of them we've learnt from sheet music because they're not normally written down. And so a lot of the songs, most of them, are passed down from one generation of boys to the next in the true folk music tradition. In other words, orally and not on the written page. And they become very much the boys' own, and they're never quite the same. Every time they sing them, they are slightly different, which is really what it's all about. And the instruments that we use have been made in the factory. They're true copies of African musical instruments in the factory African musical instruments in Grahamstown under the supervision of Andrew Tracy, who is an expert in African music. And his father, Hugh Tracy, was instrumental in collecting many of these folk songs before they died out with a tape recorder, and they're in the African Music Library in Rhodes University. And that is another source from where we have learnt some of these songs. So I thought that might be interesting to you. Also, some of the instruments that we use are made in our valley, and so they are authentic. Then we do the music as authentically as possible. We don't westernize it at all, if possible. And we do it as we receive the music. So you don't hear sort of Western-type arrangements. They're done very authentically. The first song you're going to hear is Borokeni. It was learnt by the boys in 1989 when we were touring the Caprivi Strip, just at the tail end of the war. And so we were taken around in a Hercules 130 as our private taxi, and we joined with a choir from Rundu. It was the only concert when we went to their hometown in Rundu. It was the only time that we've had tickets sold on the black market for our concerts. But there was such a demand, and I nearly got lynched outside because I was standing around. They knew I was a conductor, so they wanted me to supply tickets for them. I quickly disappeared back inside. And then it's a greeting song. Morokini means good morning, how are you, go well. And then the second one we do is an Abola song. The tradition in Africa is that you pay for your bride with cattle or money. And the translation of this song is, I've paid a whole lot in cattle and money, and look what I've got. So ladies, I hope you feel all right tonight. Then we do a more serious song called, then comes Sivela, which is also not on the program. Sivela KwaZulu. It's a song for chopping sugar cane. But there are snakes in the sugar cane, and as they chop the sugar cane down, they see the snake and take fright and go backwards. And then eventually two brave people come out from the front and stamp very hard and chase the snakes away. But all is well. And then we do Yini Gangaka, which is the more serious song. It's about, the translation is as follows. Why so long? Be quiet and listen. See the Tura. We took this child, gave him a protective charm, and sent him to the mines. When will he return with money? Because we're starving. And you'll see at the end of the song, they had their tummies because the tummies are empty. And then we do Umakot, which is a song sung at weddings to tease the bride. And the translation is from the Zulu, is the bride is ours, she's part of our family now, and she'll do all the washing and cooking for us. Once again, ladies, I hope you feel good about that. And then we do a beautiful lullaby called Tula Tula. It's probably South Africa's most famous lullaby, and not really an authentic folk song. It comes from Ifitombi, and the translation is, hush little baby, your mother will still be here in the morning. And we accompany it on panpipes, on kalimbas, which are the little hand pianos, and on the uhadi bow, which is a curved stick with a wire pulled taut between the two ends, and then pitched in the middle. And it has a calabash or a gourd on the one side as a resonating chamber, played with a piece of grass. It has two notes, and we use both of them. And then we do ibaisikile. Which is a song that tells its own story. In 1930, we rode tricycles. In 1940, we rode bicycles. In 1950, we rode motorbike-ile. And in 1960, we used taxis. It's a really nice song. And then we do for you Mavolo Volo, and that is the last song on the program, Mavolo Volo. Is an interesting song because it originated in KwaMashu, which is near Durban, and the translation of it is, there is too much violence in KwaMashu, so we won't go there. But, and Mavolo Volo is an onomatopoeic word based on the English word revolver. So the very word mavolo volo is imitating the sound of a revolver. And but funnily enough, it's had a transformation. It has now become a wedding song. So I don't know whether there's any significance there either. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your presence tonight and supporting us and this wonderful school, for which it's been such a pleasure for us to be here. And we hope now that you are going to enjoy the African music.
Oh, Mamele.
Tula, 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 Mamele, Tula, Tula, Mamele, Tula.
Oh, Tula, Tula, Mamele.
Tula, Tula, Mamele, Tula, Tula, Mamele, Tula.
Santa Tanantuana.
Everybody, you are
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Sehetti School, I'd like to wholeheartedly thank Mr. Botha, the accompanists, and of course the choir for their excellent performance. You are very good.
Cooley wants to say a word or two, so, no? Should I say it?
You may say it.
Thank you very much for having us here. Please come and receive a gift from us.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is definitely unexpected, but thank you very much for joining us this evening. I think it's been a tremendous evening in the sense this is a fitting opening to our new Bylos Centre. Thank you again, Mr. Bylos. Thank you, everybody, for coming this evening. And we would like to now invite everybody to please come and join us for a glass of wine and some cocktails as well. Thank you very much for joining us. Thank you. Thank you.